Right. Here we come towards the astronomical clock as it is doing its thingy and striking. I think some people just did a little trumpeting thing, which I wasn't quick enough to catch. But still, you can see a crowd. What this is, ladies and gentlemen, as a matter of fact, is something where I'm doing a fusion here of my Prague vlog thingamies, which are usually being published several months later. Somebody with Tourette's is shouting at the top of their voice. The football. This is a EUROWARS series installment, but obviously not in Warsaw. Yeah, you can obviously tell that this isn't Warsaw. I have to keep coming to the Czech Republic, and that doesn't stop just because I've got football going on in Warsaw. But one thing which is interesting here is that, of course, tonight is, of course, the night where in Warsaw itself, where I've come from, where I live, is the Czech-Portugal match. And so, as you see, we now have a high and die Fan Park Prague arrangement being set up, and large numbers of tourists are here in the Old Town Square, specifically because of the fact that they're going to have a large screen, which is that thing over there, presumably there with the specific purpose in mind of showing the jolly old football. So it's the Fan Park Prague, and it's right now it's 7 o'clock, as you noticed. It was an hour because the astronomical was doing its thing, so it won't be for another hour and 45 minutes until kickoff. But nevertheless, I will come back at that time and get a bit of the atmosphere which is here in Prague as the Czech team play the first of their knockouts, and hopefully not the last, although Portugal is a bit of a tall order and people are not that optimistic. First of all, what can I tell you? Here we are in the Czech Republic, but a lot of the supporters of Poland are here. Look, we've got people in Polska jerseys. There's somebody over there in a Polska jersey. That looks like, oh, that looks like a, that's a Czech jersey there. You've got a Polska jersey over there. A lot of the supporters are already out in force, getting ready for the evening's entertainment. Obviously, it's going to be here. Clearly, there's something going on there involving a stage. Maybe there's going to play music or something. You've got fans with their paint on. But in the main, you don't have, or at least so far, you don't have anything like the football atmosphere going on in this city. Even though the Czech Republic got through and the fans have got to be happy, still there's nothing like the excitement as you get in the actual city where they're taking place. Even though this is one of the teams that are going to play tonight, I have to say that during the day when I spoke about it to colleagues, most people were pretty much uninterested by it. Here we have the collections of bohemians, you know, alcoholic people that are still here as ever, hopefully going to be able to make some money off the fans who've come to watch the match. And later on I shall be back seeing what's going on. But like I say, there's nowhere near the amount of excitement going on here as I've seen actually in the Warsaw area with the Polish games going on in their own part of Euro. Here colleagues have just not, even though it's a Czech Republic game, colleagues didn't turn up at work all with flags on them or anything. Nobody seemed to be bothered. Most people that I've spoken to today are saying, are you going to watch the match? Most people aren't even going to bother watching it, even on television, let alone come out to something here. So even though the Czech Republic's managed an achievement more than Poland in actually getting through, they actually were the ones that kicked out Poland. The fans themselves, it's nothing, nowhere near the interest being shown by the fans here to compared to what you'd have in Poland. I mean, in Poland they'd already be out in force just waiting for things to happen. They'd already be walking around, they'd be singing, they'd be chanting, they'd be making a lot of noise. But here in the Georgian Dragon, which is a British bar and restaurant, they are offering watching it on this TV live. Maybe there'd be a nice atmosphere here during the match, I don't know. Certainly it's within sound of that one. I don't know whether they would allow me to order a table here within view of the television, like that one there. That would be an idea, and the best way of ordering it would be sitting it. And there we go, it's got an England flag up, that's very nice. Well, I did sit down at that George place, and I was told that if I sat down and was just keeping on ordering and drinking, that I would be able to have the place, but I couldn't order it. So I thought, oh, this is nice. I've got a nice seat within the sound of the market and the old town square and the sort of cheers going on, and also to eat something there. But to be honest with you, just in the time in which I was just trying to read the menu, I think no fewer than four or five times these women would come up and say, was I ready to order? You know, they hadn't enabled me to have the time to read the menu in peace, and part of the reason why I hadn't is that I was just explaining to them the time before that I needed more time to order, and I think that in the end they just didn't care. They just wanted to push and push and push and be aggressive. So I just thought, you know, why would I support a business that doesn't know how to treat its customers? If I treated my customers like that, clients in my case, rather than customers, I would get nowhere, absolutely nowhere. And so, I don't really appreciate having it done to me either. I can't do it to other people. Why should they have the fun of doing it to me if I can't do it to anybody else? Push them and aggress them like that. I don't think I find it funny doing it. And I certainly don't find it funny being on the receiving end of it. Anyhow, that means I'll be along later on. Oh, here we go, look. Number 26 here has got Tshuva Israel in it. And they've got minyanim every day. So if you want to have a minyanim, this is the place to come for it. So, I can't see going to a 7 o'clock, well, it's already started anyhow, so I can't see going in there halfway through. And certainly it's not an evening when I'm necessarily thinking in those terms anyway. So it's a Friday, maybe. But, you know. But I've seen these guys walking up and down here that do it, and they're jolly friendly people. And so I would be inclined on a different night to pop in there, but not when I'm already, you know, like 15 minutes too late and it's going to just disturb things. So, and I didn't bring my yarmulke anyway this time. I'm not sure they'll have any in there. And I need to eat something. And I want to relax a bit before that all kicks off. So I'm going to go back to my flat now and come out of it later on. You're